find art background. But this is such a wonderful project for people of all ages and backgrounds because you get an instant success. I call it dry fitting all your design. You probably want to take your plate and put it aside and do all of your layout, like on a tabletop, and then fit it to your dry plate before you actually glue anything, so that that way you've made sure you had enough material to cover your surface. And that's how I do it. You can use metallics as well as these permanent markers that I brought today. I've got a lot of different techniques, but they take a little longer to dry. So for today's purposes, we just use the markers that dry instantly. The glue that you're going to put onto your plate initially to put your design is this border paste. And you're going to apply it, unfortunately these are all bagged up already, but we're going to apply it with one of these little sponge rollers. And you just roll it onto the glass plate, and you put your design that you came up with it, and you put another coating of this liquid paste.
It's a lot heavier duty than regular wallpaper. And it's water soluble, so you can wash it off your hands, and even when it's dry, it's water soluble. And let that dry just a little bit, and then you can go ahead and roller this on top of it if you're using the tissue paper part right on top of the thing that you added. So you're working in layers, and you have to kind of think backwards because it's glass. So what are you going to see first? That little add-on thing. So the add-on thing has to be put on primarily, and then secondarily you put on your tissue like a background. Then when it's thoroughly dry, you'll use the polycrylic either in a spray form or in a brush. And you need to put at least 4 coats so that it's water resistant. If you're using materials on your work that is other than the paper napkins, then I like to use Yes paste. It's a scrapbooker's paste, and it's really, really thick stuff that you brush on with a brush. If you're using fabric or a heavy, fabric really, I'll say that. If you're using fabric with your napkin or any other type of material to glue onto the glass plate, like if you were using real decoupage, like if you took book plates or magazine print, if you use something like that, you have to use the Yes paste because this stuff's too watery and it'll wrinkle up your paper. So you use something that'll really give you a good, nice, flat adhesion, and that's that thick Yes paste. If you're just using the paper napkin, all you need is this border wallpaper paste and let it dry thoroughly and then coat it with a polycrylic. But the Yes paste is if you're using fabrics or magazine pages or something other than the paper napkin, because it's like a little piece of tissue and all you need for that is this glue right here. When it's thoroughly dry and all your edges with all this glue will end up being really crispy like a potato chip, so when it's thoroughly dry like that, like crisp as a potato chip, you'll take a heavy-duty emery board like you use on acrylic nails, really heavy-duty grit, and you would just gentle motion, because you don't want to tear it up, you'll use this motion, so you're kind of hitting it as a downward motion, and it kind of bonds the glue right around the glass plate edge and gives you a really good adhesion of that glue. I think it even does something chemically because it creates a friction on there. So anyway, you'll clean up the edge, then you'll turn your plate over and you'll look and see if there's anything that's stuck to the actual rim of the plate. And because we're using this type of paste, you can just use a little wet paper towel very gently and just clean that off. Then you're going to take your polycrylic and make it permanent. Anyway, it's a great process, and everybody had such a beautiful success today. I'm so proud of everyone.